now have reached a point where they can be 1 gigabit in speed if we buy 2 chips for each one, and we do. And so there are 12 supercomputers in here now, all 1 gigabit speed, which is for one. Today's graduates are really lovely. Four young persons who it's my great pleasure to just know they are so creative, they are so strong, and they're strong in character too, because the new software, although it does more, is much more difficult to answer, much more difficult to learn. People stay in here from early in the morning to late at night. We're graduating 4 people. So what we're going to do, now that I've told you a little bit about our history and a little bit about how I feel about it, and I think it is one of our mainstays and best things about us, is that we treat each individual personally all through their 2 years. We don't tell them what to do. We try to bring their talents out and let them do what they wish, as long as they're satisfying it by producing it. Juan Dominguez, Karen Sun, Chung Chin Lin, and Chris Stegman. Juan, it's been a pleasure. It's been such a pleasure knowing you. They turned in essays because they have to do a defense in writing of the work they've done. And I'm going to read a paragraph from each one of them if you don't mind. They don't know how we're going to do this. So they'll be a little embarrassed about hearing their words repeated. I'm going to read them. Juan Dominguez. Thinking as an artist, I create a path of meanings before my art represents. Art, like I have said before, is a representative of what your mind can create. But if I go deeper inside, it's like a mask, because it shows what you feel, what you dream, and what you need. Masks can be happiness, can be sadness, can be desires, can be dreams, but also only thoughts. In my 2 years at the studio here at CEC, I learned so many things. I grew up more as a person and as an artist. I learned to define what I feel, what I want, but also to define what I feel with what it intended to be. They were fabulous years, just creating what I am, going through each project, giving as much as I can, and showing it as part of me. Karen Sana writes, self-inflicted was the torturous journey I have just finished. It seemed such a long trek that only lasted a minute from China. Sometimes we wonder ourselves about whether or not our works are works of art. But in my opinion, any artwork is a work of art as long as we create our works with passion and we are pregnant with beauty and grace. The 4 animations I have designed reflect my passion, imagination, and the influence of both Western and Oriental. Defining my agenda. My artistic agenda is threefold but never limited, says Chris Stegel. First of all, I create for the sake of expression. Creating with this and this alone allows me to draw on a side of myself that is often not seen by others. The raw energy, anger, and love that rushes through my body is freely distributed onto the medium, thus keeping me level. I feel that in order to stay artistically healthy, I need to create at this level every day. Secondly, I create to learn. Whether I am painting on a canvas or animating, I learn something new every time I embark. More often than not, I learn when I allow the art something I appreciate, or I'm going to falsify it, is the ability not to be afraid of messing up, because in art, there is no right and wrong, there is only art. Lastly, I create to teach. When I create to teach, I am not setting a standard, but I'm relating my own personal views. I'm not preaching or pushing. I accept that I will not influence everyone, and I enjoy both negative and positive feedback. I try to instill personal creativity and, above all, good ideas. I am more satisfied with someone who looks at my art and thinks, I don't care for it, but it gave me some good ideas, rather than someone who enjoys it and comes away with nothing. I thought by sharing with you a paragraph from each of these final papers that they turned in, you get a little glimpse into the kind of people I'm talking about being here all the time. Our center has just been finished. This is our first adversity. So we took part of it. Eric, show us our first ad. Eric did the adversity by himself.
The Center for Electronic Communication offers a Master of Fine Arts degree in Computer Arts. In this two-year program at Florida Atlantic University, students study and grade advanced 3D computer animation. Talented artists who wish to use sophisticated computer software and hardware for artistic expression should call 954-762-5618 or visit our website at www.animasters.com.